Lydia Ko isn't the only Kiwi celebrating a big win on the golf course this week. New Plymouth's Jamie Reid is too.
Jamie is a speed golfer and he's just back from taking out the world champs in the US.
He might be a world champ, but here he's just Sir. His first day back and the high school teacher's taking a masterclass on goal setting.
For some of us, it might be better to pass NCAA level 3. Okay, that might be us getting to the top of the world.
Jamie Reid is on top of the world, having just taken out the speed golf world champs in Florida, blitzing the field with his incredibly quick and accurate play. Another Taranaki local, Robin Smith, finished in sixth place. Then the two of them combined to snatch the team's event. It's redemption for Reid, who was runner-up in 2018, just one agonising second behind the winner. And now ranked number one in the world, it seems no one can catch him.
And Jamie's here now. Congratulations, Jamie. How does it feel?
Feels very good. It's been a long battle over 4 years to try and become sort of one better than what it was back in 2018 when I came second. And then to know that all the hard work that I've put in over the last 4 years to become world champion last week, and then obviously double world champion once I won the team's event as well. It does feel very good, probably still a little bit surreal at the moment, but it's been nice coming home with the family and seeing all the friends and stuff like that. And it does make it a bit more worthwhile like that.
Jamie, give us an idea of what sort of score we're talking about here.
Yeah, so obviously a normal round of speed golf, or a normal round of golf, sorry, takes about 4.5 hours. But when you run around a golf course, it can take a lot less. So the world champs I've just played in, I shot a 71 in the first round, which is one under par, and then a 76 in the second round. And both those rounds only took me 43 minutes. So it's definitely a lot quicker than your normal Saturday club day out on a golf course.
Wow, that is impressive.
43 minutes. I mean, you've got to be pretty breathless running around and playing. And I mean, when you're lining up your golf shot, you don't want to be shaking or puffing. How do you cope with that?
Yeah, that's right. For what I do when I try and get up to my golf shot, obviously running at a high pace and then trying to play something with some sort of accuracy, it's not easy. So I've taught my body to take two deep breaths before I get over the ball, before I hit it. And then once I do that, I feel like I shut down my body. And then I just swing, go through the motions. And then as soon as I hit it, I've picked up my clubs and I'm starting to run again. And then as I'm running, I'm looking to see where my ball is in the air. And then hopefully it's landing close towards the hole. And so it makes my running a bit easier, because obviously you can hit a little bit straighter, you're going to save a little bit of time. So that accuracy is quite important in the game of speed golf.
And when you go back to playing regular golf, does it just feel so slow?
Yes, it is very, very slow. I do it more for the social occasion when I go out and play slow golf with my friends. But the hardest thing I find is when you go out and play a slow game of golf and then you go out and you shoot 75 and then knowing that I could go on and finish 4 hours earlier and shot 70, it can be a little bit frustrating in that sense there.
Oh, absolutely. And when you actually come to play normal golf, do you practice swing or do you just walk up and hit the ball like you would when you're playing speed golf?
No, so I have some practice swings when I play normal golf as well. I don't know, because I've got so much time, I guess it's you just make use of that time, and so you do have some practice swings. You might line up your shot and stuff like that, whereas in the speed golf, you don't have time for that stuff. And the good thing about not lining anything up and not having the time to think about anything is that the mental game sort of disappears when you play speed golf, and that's why I think if a lot of people took up the game and actually just went out there and hit the ball without thinking so much, their golf would be a lot better.
Good on you, Jamie. It's lovely to talk to you. All the best.